So it is 25 point AIT is converted into variable into integer, that is only 25 is stored into A. 25 is stored into A, but AIT is ignored because dot after decimal point in integer it is not allowed. Float value is typecasted into integer, so A equal to 25. Example 2, float B equal to 35, a 35 is stored into variable B, 35 is typecasted, integer 35 is integer is typecasted, means converted into the float, so B equal to 35.000. 35.00. Next, example 3 for the implicit typecasting. Char CH equal to 65. Char CH equal to 65. 65 is stored into variable CH of type character, but character means it is eligible to store only characters. Then how can it will be stored? How can it is it will store, that is 65 is typecasted means character. So ASCII value of the 65 is A, ASCII value of 65 is A, so A is stored into CH. So B means 66, C means 67, so ASCII characters are available up to 256 in C programming. Next, int sum equal to z, int sum equal to z, so here z is typecasted into corresponding ASCII value, that is 90, that is 90, 90 is the ASCII value of z, small z, so 90 is stored into variable sum integer. Next, we go for the explicit typecasting. Explicit typecasting are done by the programmer. See the example here. Int A equal to 7, B equal to 2. A equal to 7, B equal to 2. Next, A slash B equal to 7 slash 2, that is 3. Float A slash B equal to 7.0 by 2, that is 3.5 we will get. Here we are typecasting 7.0, 7 is typecasted into float, that is 7.0. If I am typecasting B, means it will become 2.0. So we will get the output 3.5. Next, I am typecasting now float of B, A slash float of B, means that is 2 is typecasted into float. So we will get the 3.5. Variable A comma B are int, A comma B are of type integers, so they have typecasted to into float data type, but the rest of the program they continue the integers only, but the rest of the program they continue with integers only. Next, we go for the preprocessor directives. So, we have completed this one. Next, we go for the preprocessor directive. Preprocessor directives. What is preprocessor? The name itself tells, preprocessing. Compiler and linker interact together to give the executable file while we are executing the C program. So whenever we are writing the C program, that is .c, test.c, this is known as the source program. So after writing this program, what we have to do, we will compile this program. After compiling this program, now it will become the test.obg. Means objected code, means assembly code related to the objected code. Okay. Now, whenever we are executing this program, now the linker will involve. It links the header files. So, after linking the header files, we will get the executable program, test.exe program means compiler and linker will involve to get the executable file. This is executable file. So now, whenever we are executing this program, we will get the output as the result. Compiler and linker interact to give the executable file. Actually, before compiling a process, is called pre-process. Before compiling, a process is called pre-process. Pre-processing. So, it is done on the source code. By the program is called pre-processing. Okay, this is the preprocessor directives. Example, definition is compiler and linker will interact with source program to give the executable file. We will get the executable program. So before compiling the source program, one process is called, that is preprocessor, preprocessing, and it is done on the source code, and this is called preprocessor. So now we will see the PPT. Compiler and linker interact to give the executable file. So why linker? Means linker links the header files. Header files means stdio.h, conio.h, math.h, all the header files are stored in the library functions. Those library functions are called header files, that is linked by the linker. Hash include stdio.h. This line is known as a preprocessor directive. Now we will see preprocessor directive, how it will work. Preprocessor means it's when the source program before compiling, one process is called preprocessing. It is done by the preprocessor. So once it is once we compile the program, it is expanded the C program, that is .obj file. It will becomes a .obj file extension. Whenever we are executing the program, automatically linker will links the header files to the object .obj file. So once it is done, header file is linked to the obj file. Now the loader will loads into the memory. So now the CPU will execute the program. So we will get the result. This is a process while we are executing from the source program into the executable file. Here the preprocessor is nothing but a collection of programs. Collection of program is already predefined functions are there. Those functions are stored in the header files. So before calling the header that functions, these predefined functions must be included. What are the features of preprocessor? Expanding the macros, expanding the files, and conditional inclusion. Macros and files we will discuss in the next sessions, in the future sessions. There are two types of the preprocessor. We have two types. Types are there. One is include, hash include, second one is hash define. Hash include is used for the header files. Hash define is used for the macros. I repeat, hash include is used for the to include the header files, that is stdio.h, codeneo.h, math.h. These are all are comes under the header files. Hash define is used for the macros. Okay, in next session, tomorrow session, we will see the macros. So here it hash means it starts with a number sign. Number sign, it is an instruction to the compiler. It's a instruction to the compiler. Okay, next tomorrow session we will see the macros and in details of the preprocessor directives. We will continue the preprocessor directives tomorrow. Tomorrow we will see the macros. Thank you all.